Respected chairman of this meeting, distinguished intellectuals and dignitaries on the stage and off the stage, my young friend and author of this very enriching book on Varya Kuntu Kunna Mohammadaji, Brother Ramesh, and my dear sisters and brothers. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. May Almighty's peace and blessings be showered upon all of you. At the outset, I am very sorry that I am not able to speak to you in your mother tongue, Malayalam. Neither would you understand my thoughts if I am going to speak in my mother tongue, Tamil. So I have to speak in English. In the stage, we have political leaders, professors, and people from the literary world, all from Kerala. I am the odd man out. I am coming from Tamil Nadu. Do you know why Brother Ramesh, Brother Abbas Ali, Brother NVM Faslullah and the group has invited me here? There is a very strong relationship between the Khilafat movement, which was a glorious movement in this part of Kerala, and Tamil Nadu. One of my earlier speakers here had slightly touched upon that topic. To be exact, I wanted to say that Maulana Shaukat Ali, along with Mahatma Gandhi, visited Calicut on 18th August 1920. And their speeches on Khilafat and non-cooperation movement led to the establishment of Khilafat Committee in Malabar. Similarly, I should also recall that a great Khilafat leader, Yaqub Hassan, was to visit Calicut on 15th February 1921 for the purpose of addressing Khilafat and non-cooperation meetings in this area. But he was prohibited by the British government. This prohibition created heartburns among the Mopalas, and this resulted in the spread of Khilafat movement in a very vigorous manner. No one can deny it. Why I am quoting all this incident is, as many previous speakers in the stage pointed out, the union government, we in Tamil Nadu do not call the government led by Sri Narendra Modi as central government. We are using the term in Tamil, Ondriya Arasu. Ondriya Arasu means federal government. So the union government has removed the names of 387 valiant freedom fighters, including Varyam Kuntu and Haji Ali Musliyar, from the Dictionary of Martyrs of India's Freedom Struggle. I congratulate Brother Ramesh and all those who have supported him in bringing this book, because if you are not going to record the true history, tomorrow
when the Sanghis are at the helm of affairs, they will erase all the glorious struggles and the heroic sacrifices made by the committed Indians. You know, a controversy erupted a few days back, rather a few weeks back. The Union Minister Rajnath Singh was speaking at a function and he said, Vinodhar Damodar Savarkar wrote the clemency petition to the Britishers on the advice of Mahatma Gandhi. Everybody was shocked. When I say everybody, everyone who is conscious of the true history of India, they will be shocked. Why? Because Savarkar wrote this clemency petition, to be exact, on November 14, 1913. That was 3 years before Mahatma Gandhi returned to India from South Africa. This is the history which Sangh Parivar wanted to impose on us, and it is very much essential that people like Ramis, who has spent 10 years in Britain visiting libraries, archives, collecting all the materials and bringing out for the first time the photo of the valiant warrior Kunnu Muhammad Haji, who has the only distinction, if you look into the annals of the freedom struggle in India, nowhere you could find that a part of the British India was liberated from the British regime, and for 6 months there was separate currency for the people over here. There was a visa system to come over here. The Sanghis, they are very much perturbed that such a valiant struggle, if it finds in the annals of Indian history, their nefarious roles will be simply erased out. So, my dear brothers and sisters, I have two more connections to come over here. No one can forget the wagon tragedy. The Maplemas, who fought the valiant struggle, they were arrested, put inside a wagon which came to Pothanur station near Coimbatore. We all know that history, and many of you know that history better than me because you belong to that region. And some of the graves of the valiant Mapla freedom fighters, including the great Ali Musliyar, is in Coimbatore. Not only that, the grandchildren of Variyakundu Kunnu Muhammad Haji are living in Coimbatore. So that is why this book on Variyakundu Kunnu Muhammad Haji should not be only in Malayalam. Inshallah, very soon you will find in your books, in your hands, you will find a very good Tamil translation of this book, translated by a person, Kolachal Yusuf, who himself is a Sahitya Academy Award. I appreciate Brother Faisal for bringing out this very good book. We should teach our generations the grand valiant struggle. It was not definitely a struggle against the Hindu community. It was the struggle launched by Variyakund was for liberating India from the clutches of British imperialism. And he is not the first Mapla to raise the revolt against the British. If you look into the Kerala history, the Indian, South Indian history, we can find Kunjali Maraikkayar. He was the first admiral of, if you want to name anyone as the first admiral of an Indian Navy, that distinction goes to Kunjali Maraikkayar and Kunjali Maraikkayar alone. And we have a place called Maraikkayar Pattinam in Ramanathapuram district. It was my former constituency, where a big valiant struggle between Kunjali Maraikkayar and the imperialist forces took place there. The 1921 revolt was not a spurt of the movement reaction. It was a tradition inherited by the Maplas in the 18th century, 19th century, and culminated with this glorious struggles by Variyakuntu Kunna Muhammad Haji. So definitely this should not only a book to be read as they have planned, we should have a clear, a very good film on Variyakuntu. I wish all the people success. Thank you.